evening. Before we do preaching, let me make two announcements, please. The first one is, please do not let your children go home until the service is finished. Because at the end of the service, we are going to pray for children, young people, and the generation yet to come, the unborn children, because they are the future men and women of God. Thank you very much. I hope you bear in mind and please let your children don't go home until we finish every program. Here is an open door for 70 people to participate in mission. It goes like this. We have Burmese mission church in London. The member is less than 20. But God has given us big vision to reach around about 10,000 Burmese Buddhist people living in London. And also to reach the people in Burma. These Burmese mission church in London is only 2 months old. As the first step, our young people produce a CD and DVD. I brought 70 copies of them. I invite 70 people to donate willingly as a free donation towards mission. The plan is to invite Muji and Stampy from Burma to sing gospel songs in London for the unreached Burmese Buddhist people in that city.
Any cinema, Muji or Stampy, you still have to check it out, right?
Let me put it this way. Yes, Stampy's singing is also there. You are right, sir. The purpose is we sell these CD and DVDs in order to invite Mutis and some other singers from Burma in order to invite Buddhist people to hear the gospel in
London. Okay,
this is called
a landing quick.
The ones marked with this white one is CD and our marked ones are DVD.
The appearance
can I request 70 people to 70 friends who are willing to donate in order to reach the poorest people in London by taking this one each and donate whatsoever the Lord asks in your heart.
The name of the Lord, my 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 Lord.
Any 70 people would like to stand up? Thank you. Thank you. Sir Martin and Sir Mamiya, would you please give one copy each and then to receive the money later on? Would you keep standing? 70
people.
Only 70 copies are there and efforts. Only 70 people have a chance to participate in this mission.
70.
Thank you very much. God bless you.
And
all people, 70 people, missionaries.
Amen.
Thank you, Sir Mamiya and Sir Martin. 70 people.
Zero on the machine.
I think we need some more people to work for the Lord.
Dr. Thank
you. God bless you. Thank
you.
After the service also, if you have not been able to decide now, you can take it after the service.
Okay, DJ Ma, some of you have to tell me what you come out of the
Shall we go ahead with the word of God as mission work is going on?
Look at the word of God, I'm going to be nervous.
This evening we will read the word of God from this written one, Genesis 32,
36.
He doesn't When they got some anointing from the My nature is not good. I have many difficulties in order to be filled
the Holy Spirit.
I have come across many temptations to come up to this far. You might have the similar or the same problem. Say, for example, some of us, having been refugee in this country, some of us might have, invented or created our story differently. The reason is to get blessing. You have overcome all these things. I don't say anyone, but some of us might be.
During the time of Jacob, what you do, you
ုံးကသရိစ္ဆာများကိုတတ်ဖြတ်ရတယ်
။ That is the time of Old Testament.
အဲ့ဒါဟာဒီမှာအခေတ္တကာလဖြစ်တယ်
။ That is the system of Old Testament sacrifice.
အဲ့ဒါကဒီမှာအခေတ္တဇက်ပူဇော်ခြင်းအနေထားရှိတယ်ဖြစ်တယ်။
That's why Jacob had to struggle a lot.
ဒါကြောင့်ယာကုပ်အနေနဲ့ပြောင်းပြောင်းဆိုသူ့မှာကြောက်ကြရတဲ့
In order to become Israel, in order to get God's blessing, he needs to do a very serious campaign.
Do you need that? That's what you have. Now, I'm going to go to the house of the Lord. I'm going to go to the house of the Lord.
That is the way of the Lord.
Hello. I'm going to go to the house of the Lord.
Where are we living now today?
I'm going to go to the house of the Lord.
You don't need to pay the price. You don't need to bear the consequence of your sin, my sin. All
things
are forgiven. You are here on the boundary. Receive and get a blessing, that's all. Your responsibility is go and get a blessing. Start to receive right now. Because Christ has already died. He has paid all the price of your sin. We are living in grace, the period of grace. That's why grace is so important. Grace covers everything. That grace forgives every sin. That grace has cleansed all our sins. And that grace is ready to release blessing. Today you may be a random job worker. Tomorrow you may be the owner of that company. Because you are Jacob, today you are Israel. Because of the grace of Christ. You are living that the way of grace so easily. We don't need to go the way of Jacob. That is the benefit of having Christ for us. Brethren, are you happy? Are you grateful to God? The first step is this. Christ has given the price of that cost. And you are living by grace. And the second step is this. We are in the period of Israel. We have gone through this period. And now we are going to receive blessing. If we look at carefully, in Galatians 3:13, Christ has redeemed us from the powers of the
law.
And verse 14, so that the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles in Christ Jesus. By biological or nature, we are not connected with Abraham. But by the blood of Jesus Christ, we are fully affiliated to the family of Abraham. Those who believe Christ are the family of Abraham. I believe the word of God with my whole heart. I believe it. And I believe by being, having faith in this. Brothers and sisters, tonight,
Let it
again. A historical day that changed your life from having under the cross to receiving all kinds of God's blessings because of Christ who has paid the cost. If you really feel that you are free from the curse, shall we give a clap to the Lord?
GPS.
At that time, I mean.
That's it.
And we bring this road direction from computer. My wife was looking at and she directed me where to go. It was daytime when we traveled. There was no problem. We preached the word of God. In the evening, we come back from where we went. It was dark. And we did not know where is the light. And my wife could not see. Look at the map. What did we do? We opened the dash beam. There's a little light in there. All the time my wife was bowing down and looking at the paper. She was looking at the roads and go this side. Take next exit or
whatsoever.
One day we look at our car. There is a light, a switch that we can easily restore. That is the story of myself. You laugh at me, I appreciate, I agree. But let me tell you your foolishness. The Bible says, believers are heirs of God. Heirs of God are supposed to be very rich. Why you are not able to give your bill at the end of the month? Why you are driving very good cars but with much credit? The Bible says believers are supposed to be very rich. For me, not knowing the sweet, we suffer one day. But if you don't know the word, you will suffer the whole life. The word of God says, Christians should be healthy. When we are sickly, come to Jesus tonight. You are already Israel. Why you are not healthy today? If you are already Israel, why you are still suffering with finance? Why you bound up before man? Why you ask for me to get money? As Zadenka says, for me, I will not bow down before man. I will never bow down before man. Only bow down before man. My wife and I suffer one night. Turning, driving about 100 miles, that's all. The next day we know when the switch is on. For us only one evening. But if you don't understand the word of God, you will suffer the whole life. Now you are suffering. Many of you are poor. Many of you are sick. Many of you are having problems. Why you are still suffering in that area? The richness.
That
was in God. Get it. Take it. Possess it. Claim it. Believe it. The difference from now will be. The difference from now will be. Who believe and who don't. Christ has already done all what he is supposed to do. It's your part to play. To believe or not. Believe in life. Believe in life. Or don't live and suffer. Which one do you want to choose? Believe and enjoy. Don't live and suffer. Life is a choice. For me, my life today is my choice of last 10 or 15 years ago. I have made my choice for the coming 5, 10 years. I have no time to tell you all what I have planned for my future. I will never bow down before men for helping. I will always kneel down and bow down before my God. Believe and enjoy or don't believe and suffer. You have to choose either one. Either one, you have a choice. Now let me tell you one more illustration. I have narrated 2-3 times. But I want to repeat it again. There was a woman in England. Very faithful servant of the Queen. Throughout her life, he served the royal family in London. On her retirement, the Queen gave her a very good certificate. She just put it inside her box. One day she got sick. She became very serious. Ambulance came. The doctors came in. They checked. They found. You are in a very dangerous position. Only 1 week. Unless you get a very good treatment. The woman asked, how much would it cost me? More than 20,000 sterling pounds. I don't have any money, doctor, she said. The doctor was looking around, checking the files and the books. The doctor found a very good certificate. That certificate contains like this. From today onward, any medical treatment, any traveling costs, any food, any clothing, anything else human needs, any bill connected to this woman. Shall be paid from the royal family budget.
But
she did not know. She did not know. She struggled a lot. After having returned, she still works for her living means. She does not need to work anymore. She does not need to pay any bill. She does not need to pay any medical treatment. All will be paid by the royal family budget. The reason, the only thing is the problem is she does not many Christians tonight. Here is our certificate. Our certificate speaks. You are heirs of God. You are supposed to enjoy the blessings of God. Spiritual blessing, material blessing, wealth and prosperity, long life, good health. That is all contained in our certificates.
Hallelujah.
Would you show me your Bible, your certificate? That is why we are Israel this evening. We might have been
jailed,
but Christ has given the prize. There is no grace. We are forgiven already. Not simply forgiven, but we are given. You will have not because you ask not. We should ask. Just ask. We have a very good promise for
honor.
No other language has that sort of
promise.
Many of we promise Christians. He is waiting. says like this.
When
the children of God is about to pray, God and the angels in heaven try to give attention to the prayer of His children on earth.
Listen
what they are praying. Be quiet. Listen carefully.
What they are.
But many Americans pray.
God,
I'm going to holiday.
Take care
of my dog. Then God is very disappointed. Many American Christians need God to take care of their dog. We promise Christians here. We tell God's goodness. We need God not only for doctrine prayer. God spoke to someone. Men look at the upward
appearance.
I look at the heart. And therefore he let him anoint dead the little one. The young baby. Shepherding is a sheep. Not a skillful person. Not educated person. Not university graduate. Not a rich man. But because of his heart, God appointed him to be the king of Israel. Now, Baptist Christians, we are minority in this country. Most of us are not skillful. Most of us are not highly educated persons. And our outward appearance will be different from other people. I can sense myself in England. How people look at me. Because of my skin color. I know
too.
God look at your heart, my brother. My sister. Barnes Christians. Stand up now. Rise up in the name of Jesus.
Yes, she can tell.
Amen.
God is looking at your heart. He does not bother about where you come from. He does not bother about your outward appearance. He does not bother about what your education is. Your heart. Have a big faith. Have a big vision. You will see me after 5 years. And now receive blessing from the Lord. Today you and I are in Sunday. Because the word of God says, quite clearly in Romans chapter 8, verse 16 and 17.
Roma kanji shi and then
and also Galatians 3, 13 and 14. If we are children of God, we are heirs of the kingdom. We have everything claimed by faith. Step into it. Your life will be changed. Your life will change. As I said, I have changed already. My life will change again and again. See me after 5 years. You will not see me as today.